I had gone to the city of the trash pandas with one goal in mind, to find my brother, and I wasn't going to leave until I either found him or received something more tangible than one man's word to indicate that my brother was not in the city. If he wasn't in the city, I would leave, and the city could go to hell. Looking at it, I kind of thought it already had. And this concludes another chapter of The Diary of Claire Redfield by Rebecca Chambers. Perhaps we'll continue that next month. Welcome to another horror night here at twitch.tv/purblindgamer. I hope everybody is doing well and had a good weekend. I did. Had some fun and... yeah. Got some things done, more things not done. Recovered from work a bit. Hey, Zatara, welcome in. How are you tonight? Yeah, not even a week yet. But, and apologies for missing streams this week. I had other events and yesterday. Oh, say next week. Yeah, I guess I do. Maybe this will take a longer time to get back to. Sometimes I say next year. Oh, that's nice, Zatara. You have tomorrow off work, and you're playing some Hades. Oh, that's fun. I've seen people streaming that. Yeah, I realized we were supposed to hopefully finish Doom reboot on Wednesday, and I missed that. And then I missed Short Horror Saturday, so... We will finish Doom, and I'll try and do a makeup short horror stream, maybe tomorrow. And because of that, I didn't get to remind everybody that I would be drinking a yogurt citrus alcohol cocktail for the successful community challenge. So because of that, I won't be doing that tonight. I'll be doing it on Wednesday instead. And I hopefully can start stream early on Wednesday, because... They're kicking us out of the building at work early. But thank you to everybody who came out, took up my last couple of streams. Last Sunday, damn, we started Resident Evil 2, the GameCube version. And that Saturday we played, Vanish and, is it Clap Clap? And before that, we were dooming it up. Yeah, I did. I did look at the PlayStation version for comparison after people were talking about it last stream, and it does look like the GameCube got a graphical upgrade. Not as noticeable as the PS1, the Resident Evil 1 remake on the GameCube, but still did smooth out the graphics somewhat. But we'll see what kind of progress we make tonight. Talking to my roommate about it, who he's played Resident Evil 2 before, like the original. Mentioned, I didn't go to get the crossbow because didn't have much ammo, and there were a whole bunch of zombies eating the gun shop owner. He was like, oh, probably should have gotten that. A lot of times in Resident Evil, you don't get another chance to get the weapon during the game. So, like, shit. A part of me wants to restart the game and try to get it, but that would be foolhardy? Oh, shoot, really? I wonder why. I hope we're not having serious internet network issues and that it gets its ass in gear. But anyway, so now we'll play the game without the crossbow, so just the handgun and whatever else we can find, which will be more soon. And melee weapons. And knives are all very well and good, but I want a sword in Resident Evil. Yeah. A chainsaw. Chainsaw that you don't need to worry about fuel about. Wait. Resident Evil is different from Doom, isn't it? Of course, in the new Doom, you do have to worry about fuel for the chainsaw, so... and I did start a new community challenge tonight. I know I've been promising I would. But, oh, internet issues have been par for the course, or the lack of crossbows. Did you know I really don't have many crossbows in the summer? I don't have many crossbows in the winter. I should work on that. Yeah, need more weapons in my life. But, I was going to try and do a plug and play, like a TV game on real hardware, but I need to get an adapter. I realize we don't have one for our TV here. It's got old, like, RCA cables, so starting a different community challenge tonight. I should really check and make sure I can get those working. A lot of things it's hard to get working. I did ask for help on the DXWin forums to get Spy Muppets, the PC port, working, and they've been giving me some advice, so hopefully I will get to stream that. Yeah. I'll talk more about my plans for upcoming streams at the end. Let's get back into RE2. GameCube version. There we go. Oh yeah. And to briefly catch us up on the game, we play Claire Redfield, who is the sister of Chris Redfield from the first game. Her brother is missing, and she's come to Raccoon City to find him. She runs into a policeman named Leon, who knows her brother, but they get separated in a car crash, and she has to head to the police station to try and find him again. And at the police station, the whole city's overrun by zombies, and a lot of the police officers have been turned, and we've find one police officer who's still human but has experienced a bit of nibbling, and he said that it's been over a month since the events of the first game, when our brother and a couple of other officers were investigating strange deaths near an old mansion and discovered zombies and zombie dogs, and then were betrayed by their commander, who created a super soldier that they had to kill. And according to this officer, Chris and the other survivors from the first game have gone on some new mission after nobody believed them about zombie outbreaks, and they haven't heard from them in about 10 days. So we still haven't seen Leon here, and we're not much closer to finding our brother. And then the extremely rude policeman kicked us out of the room and telekinetically locked the door and won't let us back in to pillage the place. So that probably means that in 3 streams he is going to come back as an extra tough zombie. I know how these games work. Well, I've played one of them before. And oh, in the remake, Leon has a lot more facial animations than in this one. Yeah, I can believe that. Except how would you see it if you're always looking over his shoulder in the remake, huh? Yeah, I'm changing up the camera. And we've, gone through most of the police station that we can so far, and I think we're about to come up against the only way we can move forward is to come up against our first tougher enemy, which is, I don't know, I've been calling him Ceiling Venom, but that's a bit of a mouthful, so we'll just call him Wall Venom, or Symbiote, but I like Wall Venom. Oh, a YouTube video of the remake that shows off how much better the facial animation is. And I hope you guys like me, constantly dying and constantly moaning about every bullet I fire and every typewriter ribbon I use, because that's how I play survival horror games. Resource management. I should be glad I don't play RTS games more often. It's a great intro. Hmm. Hey, thanks. Sorry about that. I restarted a couple of things and logged off and back onto the network, so hopefully it's in better shape now, and I just edit the VODs together with lossless cut, which actually makes it surprisingly easy.
Resident Evil 2.
Yeah, I still don't have my controller working. That's another thing I was going to look into. So,
Resident
we'll
Evil
be
2.
playing with the keyboard. You once again stepped into the world of survival horror. Or non-survival horror, because you're gonna die. Good luck. You'll need it. Hey, so nice they don't have stamina bars in this game. This rude telekinetic police officers. So it was. Which way was. Flashing doors are locked, which is a nice touch. And there's another door into that room. Nothing to care about. The office. Oh, that's just giving us a hint where the safe was. Nothing is wrong. September 28th, night shift, George C. Scott. We tried to mess with it, it just slaughtered us pretty good. Wait. Wait. I'm sorry, I went the totally wrong way. This is me being able to read maps. Being able to read maps. Hey, Rocket Kev. Welcome in. How are you doing tonight? You guys, please go check out Rocket Kev. Were you streaming lately? Ooh, which retro games? And there's some people that would call what I'm playing right now retro. Heck, there are some kids who'd probably call the Wii U retro. They'd be wrong. Nice. My weekend was pretty good, thanks. Got some things done, got to do fun stuff, hung out with my roommates, went to a night market. call my father because it was his birthday. Oh, Final Fantasy 1 on the NES. That's pretty tough, isn't it? Can I just say that the Night Market would be an excellent name for a, like, free indie horror game on itch? There's nothing more. Symbol of the Raccoon City Police Department. Shit. Do you guys see it out the window? Just barely. I think that's supposed to be a glimpse of the wall venom. Oh, thanks. Yeah, Zatara. I had to reset a couple things, but we did. So hopefully no more problems. And I'll edit the VODs together. Yeah, a lot of leveling up. Is there a lot of grinding and turn-based battles in FF1? So they're kind of low. I wonder if aiming down will help. Discarded files. Yeah, it's around the sign there, isn't there? But been enjoying it? Close switch for the shutter. Oh, but the cord is cut. So, I think we've been pretty good at picking up all the items, so it's not like we can... Oh, listen, you can hear it crackling really faintly. Playing some... Oh. Okay, it's going to attack us any minute. The head is missing. It seems to have been twisted off. Wait, is that a door? Right. It's one of the card locks. Pun intended. Bullets to kill, but it took away a good amount of our health. Ha, thanks. And guess what, guys? That's the only wall venom that appears in the game. We will never have to deal with them again. So that's a relief. Oh. It had better lighting. The liquor is... Oh, liquor! Like, I thought you meant, like, a bottle of liquor. So is that what their real name is? Liquors? I can see why. God, I wonder if they twisted that guy's head off with their tongues. Window's boarded up. Oh, there's another herb? Oh, thanks. That's, yeah, feel free to shout out if I, like, walk by items. Oh, yeah. Saying it could have been blinking. Actually, I think I'll indulge in a bit of herb right now. Yeah. Oh shit, I'm still on caution? Wow. Looks like a door, but we can't clear things away from it. Really? You can combine two herbs to make a big herb. Interesting. Could you do that in the first game? Maybe I just never tried. So does it heal, like if you use two at once, does it heal more total than if you use like one at a time? How much does it heal if you just eat one herb? But then, I guess the temptation is to combine two herbs and wait until it's danger. Yeah. Since part of the suspense is you don't know the exact amount. Okay. So using a double herb is way more efficient. Increased by a state. Oh. Gotcha. This barricade's been made in a hurry. That probably means something is going to jump out of it. Okay. I should try the door. Bigger room. Nothing alive in here yet. Empty soda cans and junk. Nothing else. Map. Oh. Thought it might have an indicator of where Chris went. Looks like there was a recent accident here. There's a lot of recent accidents in this city. Operation report. September 26th. The Raccoon Police Department was unexpectedly attacked by zombies. Many have been injured. Even more were killed. During the attack, our communications equipment was destroyed, and we no longer had contact with the outside. We have decided to carry out an operation with the intent of rescuing as many survivors, any possible survivors, as well as to prevent this disaster from spreading beyond Raccoon City. The details of the operation are as follows. Security of armaments and ammunition. Chief Irons has voiced concern regarding the issue of terrorism due to a series of recent unresolved incidents. On the very day before the zombies' attack, he made the decision to relocate all weapons to scattered intervals throughout the building as a temporary measure to prevent their possible seizure. I like how they have an explanation for something that you would just accept in most games, like it. That's how it is for gameplay reasons. Unfortunately, this decision has made it extremely difficult for us to locate all the ammunition caches. It has become our top priority to recover these scattered munitions. To unlock the weapon storage. As stated earlier, it will be extremely difficult to secure all the ammunition. However, a considerable supply still remains in the underground weapon storage. Unfortunately, the person in charge of the key card used to access the weapon storage is missing, and we've been unable to locate the key. One of the breakers went down during the battle, and the electronic locks are not functioning in certain areas. It has become a top priority to restore the power in the power room and secure those locks. Recorder, David Ford. I wonder if that's the card we got, though. September 27th, 1 o'clock p.m. The West Barricade has been broken through, and another exchange ensued. We sheltered the injured in the confiscation room on the first floor temporarily. 12 more people were injured in the battle. Recorder, David Ford. 3 additional people were killed following the sudden appearance of an as-yet unknown creature. This creature is identified by missing patches of skin and razor-like claws. However, its most distinguishing characteristic is its lance-like tongue, capable of piercing a human torso in an instant. Their numbers, as well as their location, remains unknown. We have tentatively named this creature the Licker, and are currently in the process of developing countermeasures to deal with this new threat. Countermeasures like shooting it 5 times. Me? I'm not dead yet, give me 5 minutes. It's a fireplace. An oil painting hangs above it. The title is... Oh, did it... Stream cut out for a second. A Sacrifice to the Hellfire. Cheap viewers. Don't call my viewers cheap. Absolute zero icks. That's rude. I would like to apologize to anybody who feels that their honor has been importuned by certain bots recently. We have dealt with the matter accordingly. A Sacrifice to the Hellfire. Looks like someone chained up. That we cannot take those, you know, pike axes from the suits of armor. This sucks. Seems to be anything to find here. Searching under. Make sure I searched everywhere. Knows where there could be another box of bullets. We need more bullets. Shaft. It's dark inside. Yeah, well, most people don't stick lights in their ventilation shafts. Crawl through anyway. Interesting. When you report the individual bots, they get banned, but Twitch hasn't learned how to, like, identify them first. This is hard to based on the names. Something is written here. Please keep quiet while meetings are in session. Gonna have to sneak past a zombie meeting. Yeah, I think we are. Much my plans of sneaking. Jeez. Now pick that off. I think I could run past.
Stairway. Wait.
Okay, so that other door is locked, but it's possible I can pick it. Wait. Herbs. All the herbs. Yeah, I mean, that's part of the game. It's like dying and learning where to go. This music. Yeah, that's part of the game. I've probably... This is where this music was originally from, and I've just heard it used in other games. A special kind of key is required. Yeah, I mean, putting my foot through the metal. Ooh, is that a typewriter? Oh! Oh good, we've got 4 increments now. But I'm in such bad shape, I don't know if I should save. Oh, hello. I can develop film here. I was about to say it looks like a dark room. You wanna bet there's gonna be some puzzle attached to that. Zombies over on the operation room, and another battle broke out. Overran. We lost 4 more people, including David. We're down to 4 people, including myself. We failed to secure the weapons cache, and hope for our survival continues to diminish. We won't last much longer. We've agreed upon a plan to escape through the sewer. There's a path heading from the precinct underground to the sewage disposal plant. We should be able to access the sewers through there. The only drawback is that there's no guarantee that the sewage disposal plant is free of any possible dangers. For example, zombie sharks. We know our chances in the sewers are slim, but anything is better than simply waiting here to die. In order to buy more time, we locked the only door leading to the underground, which is located in the eastern office. We left the key behind in the western office, since it's unlikely that any of those creatures have the intelligence to find it and unlock the door. I pray that this operation report will be helpful to whomever may find it. Recorder, Elliot Edward. Doors in the eastern office. The keys in the western office. Oh, yes, that must be the locked door there, and then... Alright. I'm gonna see if that door can be... that lock can be picked. Isn't it nice we don't have to worry about kerosene? Thank you. copy paper and office supplies. Like zombie supplies. Not easy catching me when you're stupid, is it? Now it's one of the card locks. Is that herbs? Nah, just a potted plant. Hopefully in this game, zombies cannot navigate stairs. Reload. No. Super herb, yeah. I'll need that once I get bitten another time or two. What are these? Does our map cover this? Turns, but the door won't pop. Hey. Heard the ding, it should be back now. Something is written on the mounting. The god of sun and the god of moon, their gaze upon me is the only thing that can release the red soul. Of the god of sun and the god of moon. Oh, you're in ads? I wish there was some easy way that OBS would tell me if I could threw people into ads, but I guess it's different people in ads at different times. It reset, but it's working all right now. I wonder why sometimes we have an issue with that and other times we have no issue. Something seems to have been placed here. Okay, so we'll have to find some sun and moon thing. And we're also looking for a unicorn. I think that's what it was. That's the only usable door there. At least whoever made the maps, the erased the doors that had been sealed. So, proactive cartographer. Just trash. Hello, Dom Retro. Welcome in. How are you doing tonight? Stars. Yeah, hope your Sunday's going well. It's going all right, thanks. Yeah, it seems like a good game so far. I feel like I'm a little more confident than I was in one, but it's also different. Like, it seems to expect you to run away from more encounters. But, yeah, glad to be playing it. I'm enjoying it so far. And I'm glad it's shaping up to be an interesting story. Though I doubt they can top the twist from Resident Evil 1. That was a big twist. Nothing suspicious or out of the ordinary. I'm guessing that this is the Western office they were talking about. Trophies, one of them reads, Marksman Contest Winner, Chris Redfield, that's my brother. Always shooting things. Picture of the Stars members. I think that's Jill there. You guys can't see my mouser. I think Jill is the second one kneeling from the right. And I think that's Captain Wesker standing behind her. That might be Barry standing there, I don't know. I don't recognize Chris. Is that a fish? It looks like one of those, you know, big mouth Billy Bass on the walls there. Hey, who says the cops in Raccoon City don't have fun? A replica of a gun? The owner is probably a member of the NRA. Okay, but can we take it in case we need to swap out a gun with a fake one and disable a trap? Nope. Yeah, Claire's new to this. She doesn't know how these things work. She's not a policewoman. Chris's diary. Ooh. Oh, shit. You're right, Stock. If that's... God. It's creating a new VOD every time. It's not supposed to, but if it is, that's... That's gonna be a pain in the neck to edit together. God. Especially since I've stopped recording backups on my hard drive. Just because my hard drive's kind of full. Certain games, whom I could name, take up about 100 gigabytes. Doom Reboot. As soon as we finish it, I'll free up space and I'll start making temporary backups of my streams on my hard drive. Yeah. Chris's diary is private, but I'm his sister. I've been reading his diary since we were 10 years old. Oh, we're not gonna read it? The Unicorn Medal. We can put that into the fountain in the, entryway. Disorganized and untidy. It probably reflects the owner's personality. Again, that's my brother. Oh, it's been 7 VODs. Oh, fuck me. That's gonna be fun. Wonder if I should... Yeah, real quick. Record the rest of it in case this trend continues. The diary might be locked. Let's see if we can read it. Chris's diary. August 8th. I talked to the chief today, once again, but he refused to listen to me. I know for certain that Umbrella conducted the T-virus research in that mansion. Anyone infected turns into a zombie. But the entire mansion went up in that explosion, along with any incriminating evidence. Since Umbrella employs so many people in town, no one is willing to talk about the incident. It looks like I'm running out of options. August 17th. We've been receiving a lot of local reports about strange monsters appearing at random throughout the city. This must be the work of Umbrella. August 24th. With the help of Jill and Barry, I finally obtained information vital to this case. Umbrella has begun research on the new G-Virus, a variation of the original T-Virus. Haven't they done enough damage already? We talked it over, and have decided to fly to the main Umbrella HQ in Europe. I won't tell my sister about this trip, because doing so could put her in danger. Please forgive me, Claire. See? He knew I was going to read his diary, so it's cool. Forgive him, and he'll forgive me for reading his private papers. It's a picture of a young man. There's a good chance it's her boyfriend. And dig those CRT monitors. Jacket, is that going to provide armor? No, that would be silly. Is that a medkit thing? A rookie's desk. Okay, let's talk about the cardboard boxes and more talk about the first aid kit! Jeez, Claire. Files from past cases. Nothing useful here. Various devices. This must be where they gathered information. I know, Dom Retro, they're clearly teasing us. Maybe somebody already took the first aid spray out of it. Yeah, Claire's all about the herbs. And the cardboard boxes. Nothing. Making sure there's nothing else here. Quite a subversive message for the 90s. Herbs, they're good for you. Here. Is that a... No, not a shotgun, just a glauncher. What is a glauncher? We're going to find out. Oh, that's all. But the glauncher will be great against the wall venoms. The fax coming through? Oh, cool. Nowadays, our faxes at work are basically just glorified PDFs. I know, so elegant, so 90s. Federal Police Department, Internal Investigation Report. Hey, sentient program, welcome in. How are you doing tonight, dude? Mr. Chris Redfield, Raccoon City Police Department, STARS Division. As per your request, we have conducted our internal investigation and discovered the following information. 1. Regarding the G-Virus, currently under development by Umbrella Incorporated. So far, it is unconfirmed that the G-Virus even exists. We're continuing with our investigation. Well, that's good to hear, sentient. 2. Regarding Mr. Brian Irons, Chief of the Raccoon City Police Department. Mr. Irons has allegedly received a large sum of funds in bribes from Umbrella Incorporated over the last 5 years. He was apparently involved in the cover-up of the Mansion lab case, along with several other incidents in which Umbrella appears to have direct involvement. Mr. Irons has been arrested under suspicion of rape on 2 separate occasions during his years as a university student. He underwent psychiatric evaluation as a result of the charges, but was released due to circumstantial evidence, as well as his phenomenal academic standing. As such, extreme caution is advised when dealing with him. Jack Hamilton, Sectional Chief, Internal Investigations, United States Federal Police Department. What? School sweeping horrible crimes under the rug to protect students? Well, the only thing more ridiculous than that would be corruption at high levels of police departments. But, I mean, is this even realistic? I mean, in the first game, Yeah, we'll probably have to kill the police chief. Also, not to nitpick, but it wasn't mail, it was a fax. I think we found everything. Wait, is that an herb on the desk? Oh no, it's a mug full of pencils, sorry. How dare I question the lifelike realism of sin, of Resident Evil 2? No, I'm just saying, yeah, there's, you see, there's that much truth in it. What else could they be telling the truth about in this game? Zombies, perhaps? So... hopefully the way back to the fountain is going to be clear, except for that one zombie which we can hopefully run around again. But, I don't know. That hastily constructed barricade worries me. And we didn't... Hey, this... And we didn't find the key because that's on the eastern office because we're on the second floor. Didn't specify the first floor. Ventilation shaft. It's far too small for an adult to fit into. Great, we just need to find a child. Oh, your brother had a trailer for it, and you guys used to watch it over and over. It came on a PS, PlayStation, like, demo disc. It's cool. I didn't get into PlayStation until later. I didn't remember they had sometimes trailers as well as demos. Oh, PSN, is that PlayStation? Oh, PlayStation Magazine, right. I think I have a couple of those that I snagged from the Sci-Fi Club when they were getting rid of stuff in undergrad. And that's another card lock. Can I try and look at these? Yeah. And I think we got to go back to... fountain now. Not regularly sentient. I would ever have a subscription to them. I think it was more like I would buy some randomly now and again. But I did get some demo discs, or some even had full games on them. And, you know, PC Gamer, Computer Gaming Strategy Plus. Some of them had pretty fun articles, too. Yeah, because there's no way to get across, so... demos. It was a cool way to, you know, discover demos, or sometimes try demos you wouldn't normally, because, you know, I'm never going to play Sammy Sosa's High Heat Softball, but if I got a demo for it, I might give it a go. I have to find a flashlight or something.
Oh, fuck!
What's that? That was a lot of zombie arms. Was it just a horde of zombies? Might have done some damage, we'll never know. We did search this one, right? Alright, that's the classroom, isn't it? Whatever. I know we need to get back to the fountain. Fuck! No idea if that's doing damage or just scaring you, but be careful to keep away from the boarded up windows. Of course, this window is smashed, so. Going to become relevant that George Scott was on duty. Here the chest. We're about to lose the unicorn, so. Precinct key. But look, it does have a spade, though. Should I? God, I've been playing long enough, it worries me that I haven't saved, but I feel like I haven't really done enough to merit a save. Got, what, 4 ribbons? Officers would be carrying some ammo at this point. Hey, this is the one we saw from that hint demo. Thanks, Rocket Kev. A copy machine. Patrol report. September 20th. Reporter, Sergeant Neil Carlson. We received a report of a suspicious individual skulking around the sewers in the outskirts of Raccoon City. I searched the area and located the individual, but he ran away before I was able to question him. I recovered the following items: a small amount of C4 plastic explosive, an electronic detonator, 9x19 parabellum rounds, infrared scope, broken. So where'd you file that there, evidence, Sergeant Carlson? I I could use that evidence. Or, convictions. Yeah, like I have a conviction, I need to shoot the wall venoms with parabellum rounds. Conviction. Oh. Okay, this is making me feel better. Like, maybe I should save. Raccoon City data files, mostly on Umbrella Incorporated. Are those, like, reels of tape or what? Yeah. I don't know. 2-inch tape or 16mm film. Visual materials. Raccoon City has not upgraded to VHS quite yet. Someday soon. Saw her, like, how they animated her hair. Searching every shelf. Point-and-click adventure rules. A pile of investigative reports. There might be a crank on top of the shelf. Imagine what's making those banging noises. It is a crank. Hey. Wouldn't be Resident Evil without a crank. It took me a while to figure out where to use it in the first one. It was pretty cool, like, raising and lowering. Wait, isn't that a door? Oh, I guess not. I guess it's just a cabinet. And Claire has nothing to say about it. Others were spade locks on this floor. I guess I'll have to go back and check. I think I got everything out of here. Since I think the door at the top of the stairs was locked too. Oh right, that's locked door was by the zombie. I'm probably gonna run past him like 10 times, and then on the 11th time he's gonna bite me and kill me. Thinking of running past things. He thinks he's waiting to surprise me, but the joke's on him. I'm over here. Like, how many of the Resident Evil games have you guys played? Ah, drats, it's a diamond. Thank you. are mostly watching other people play them. Sentient. So Dom Retro, you played 1, 2, and then skipped to 5. Oh, you remember this part, Sentient. Yeah, Code Veronica on the PS2. It's one of the other ones I actually have. That one seemed pretty good. One of these days I'll have all the Resident Evil games. But, not every game on every system, that would be excessive. Wait, should I dump something in the chest? I mean, am I really gonna use the knife? God forbid I have to. Hey, here's my Code Veronica. I feel like if you happen to get an RE fan, they'd think that was awesome. Shoot, I forgot. It's this way. Right. Veronica was pretty hard. Who's Veronica? Well, if you ever read the Archie comics, she's the brunette. I think that's right, isn't it? I did not read the Archie comics. So pretending to know what I'm talking about. Do you guys think I should save here? Like, I haven't saved since we, like, fought the first wall venom. And I'm not, I wouldn't say I'm doing especially good. Yeah. No, I think. Yeah. Just in case I did. Yeah, now that I have 6 Inks Ribbons. I mean, I don't have a lot, but I have 6, and I ended, like, the RE1 remake with, like, 10 ribbons, or more than 10, so I'm like, shouldn't hoard them too much. But, no, I think it was the brunette is Veronica and the blonde is Betty. And I wasn't making that up, but I can't swear to it. Mostly see them in ads and the few Sonic the Hedgehog comic books I bought. I said, oh, Code Veronica was weird even for the time that it came from. I mean, so many Resident Evil games. I was always curious to try Resident Evil Survivor, even though I know it's supposed to be not great. Here or and then we cleaned that up pretty thoroughly. Yeah, this. Dragon of the West, thank you so much for the gift sub. That's so kind of you. Or not the gift sub, the resub, I mean. You guys, please go check out Dragon of the West. Oh yeah, I saw you were playing some Celeste today, Dragon. I was lurking for a bit. How did that go? Yeah. Dragon plays some horror games, some platform games, different kinds of things. His streams are great. I'm enjoying it, you know? Overthinking everything, and it's pretty tense. But it's fun so far. More zombies in the first game, it seems. Them to run past and fight. Have you played this one, Dragon? Run these games. A club. I knew when I was playing the remake, I think like a top speedrunner came in to say hi. Which is always cool. Yeah. Wait. And then this is just I went on the wrong side. Ooh, a coffee maker. So we can throw a hot coffee at the liquors, burn their tongues. Oh no, it was through the main office we get to the stairway. Which, I know there's a spade door on the west side of the second floor, so. But since we're in this quadrant, I'll just check the others. It says it's only one, isn't it? I still remember that scene where the zombie dogs jumped through the windows in first Resident Evil. So now I'm always kind of worried about windows. Oh yeah, shoot. That zombie in the lower left corner? He's playing possum. We don't want to go near him. Doom 3 Resurrection of Evil. They're all alive. Did we not? Oh, even this corpse? Because I think we looted this corpse before, but yeah. I kinda like that, though. Yeah. Have these dead bodies scattered around and you don't know which ones are gonna get up and attack you. It's kind of realistic. Wait, where's... Yeah. But it's like you don't know which ones are zombies and which ones are just corpses. Like, unfortunate fellow who had his head twisted off. Sorry, where's... Anyway, the door's here, right? It's like you can't see the door, but it's... So Is it? Someone mentioned that before. It's like if they have blood around their body, then they're not zombies. Because the guy without a head definitely had lots of blood around him. There's this guy. Oh yeah, he's like, his body's bloody, but he has no blood. Is that a report? It looks like a report. And now, just a blank notepad. Anyway. I really like that if they attack you when you're kneeling down, or when they're on the ground, I mean, you can kick their heads off. Oh, this is locked from the inside. Oh yeah, thanks Rocket Kev. Yeah, but I gotta pass the chest again, I might as well. Okay, no blood pool. I'm lying face down. Oh yeah, agreed, we'll need him. And hey, Wirebrain, I don't think I said hello. How are you doing tonight? Oh, there's one upstairs too, wow. Well, I may as well make a super herb. Sorry. How are you, Wirebrain? Oh, I see there, except, shoot. Got no space. Oh, Resident Evil 2 is one of your favorites. Nice, Wirebrain. But I have to pick them up, wouldn't I? Or will I try? Oh, three green herbs doesn't do anything. It's just, oh right, because like, the green super herb. Just, I don't know, is it worth? Eh, what the heck? I've got enough in the chest. Yeah, I'll use one. Oops. Probably not the super herb now, since I'm only at caution. I'm still at caution! This is frightfully imprecise. Okay. So we gotta go all the way back to the other staircase. So which version of this did you play, Wirebrain? We're playing the GameCube version. Interesting, so like, well, PS2 and Dreamcast. So is it like in addition to the word, the little, like the heart monitor line changes color to give additional gradations? Okay, PS1, so the original. Gotcha. I guess that is useful. Useful if you have color vision. But that's nice. That would be a lot meaner if it was just like, find caution, danger, and you can figure out where you are within each one once you drop to another one. Yeah, I'm enjoying this one. Are there a lot of differences between the PS1 version and the Dreamcast version? Yeah, real classics. The REs. Yeah, we're doing decently. I say that like I know. I'm just gonna leave the crank in here because who knows when I'll need it. So the Dreamcast and GameCube are both similar, and they're based on the PC port, which we almost played, but decided not to. Square-shaped. Okay. You can't, like, zoom in and turn them around like you could in the GameCube RE1. I think I'll... dump that in there. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Thanks, Warbright. I was just wondering about that. Like, whether... yeah, what are the odds I'm going to get stuck somewhere where I need to save and can't get to a crate? So... yeah, I guess the rest is all essentials. Ah, no. And I love that you can stack all the ink ribbons in one big pile. And same with the ammo. Gotta be back and forth. Here. I was kind of worried that if you go back and forth too many times, that another wall venom is going to creep through the window. That's the door. Yeah, no, definitely I've done everything I can on this floor. For now. Yeah, liquors. Right. We found a police report that said, we're temporarily calling these things liquors, and we don't know what they are or where they come from, but they kill people. But it already christened them all venoms. Because they look a lot like Venom. Or the other symbiotes from Marvel Comics. That first one was tough, so I, like, searched the whole floor that I could access before... before I faced it. Got past it. So I says, liquor? I barely even... and then she decapitated me with her tongue. Liquors do not have senses of humor, or, indeed, any flesh covering their brains. Figure. Just leaving one zombie alive in each of the bigger hallways will be a good way to save on some ammo. This was the one that was sealed from the other side. And yes, we need suns and moons. Shit.
Help me!
Wait, there is a child. Oh, sure, Rocket Kev. Drink something in a minute. I have to put some bullets in this zombie cop. We dead. Cheers. Suppose we can't call it ice water anymore, but it's ice adjacent. Oh god. Oh, so that. So that'll even tell you if they're going to get back up or not. That'd be useful in knowing whether or not you need to keep putting rounds in them when they're on the ground. Oh yeah, now I see. I think I thought it was part of his shadow, but I think the circle is blood. Hey kid, want to crawl through a ventilation shaft? Oop, guess you already did. Far too small for adult to fit into. Mm-hmm. Oh, so the story's better in the older version. And they're all right, because there are two scenarios for each character. And I'm glad I am playing this instead of the remake. Except for playing the old remake of the first one, I want to play the originals of the whole series eventually. The key is useless now. I really love that they tell you that. I mean, you know. Hey, alone in the dark, you want to take a few notes? Oh, you can't. This game was made 6 years later.
Leon!
Is that? It is Leon.
Claire, you made it.
Yeah. Have you seen a little girl around here?
Yeah, you just missed her. Who is she?
I don't know. But it's too dangerous for her to stay here alone. Leon, I'll go look for her. You go and find us a way out of here.
Of course. But before I forget, here's a radio.
Oh.
That way we can keep in touch if something comes up.
Oh, good. Yeah. None of this information looks useful. I'll find my brother after I find this random kid. Keep her safe. You know, I kind of feel like you should have detained her and tried to keep her safe, Leon. Protect and serve, all that good stuff.
I'll go look for her. You go and find us a way out of here.
Claire's taking charge. I like it. Desk is locked. Will you use the lockpick? Of course you will. I hope it doesn't break. Flame rounds. Still need the shotgun though. Soon we'll have the shotgun. Yes. Is he blocking this hallway, or it's a dead end, but... Ah, glad I went down the dead end. Door is nailed shut. It doesn't look like I can pass through here. You mean without... removing the planks nailed over it? No, I would not think you could pass through it under those circumstances. Okay, big room, but pretty empty. Oh, Leon's kind of a boob, and... some of the characters are pretty cartoonish in the remake, but... Somebody was saying that Leon was kind of an idiot in this game, too, I think. an idiot, but something. Look like movable bookshelves. Search them all. Wait, is that a switch? Yeah. Vent? Guess not. Nice, a giant painting or tapestry. Wish we could get a better look at it. None of these books appear to be useful. He's more dedicated, but he's not a complete moron in this game. And I know Leon becomes a character in some of the later games, too. But I like that they have, you know, some of the different characters appear in different sequels. Company data files primarily on Umbrella Incorporated. You know how evil companies are never, like, the Umbrella sole proprietorship? Leon wants to keep everyone he knows safe. You know, that's a pretty reasonable goal. The door is not flashing. And I think this is just within the room. I'll check the upper level. And probably get kicked off the edge by a giant snake. Many books on the shelf are about chemistry. Many books on this shelf were about hidden boxes of handgun ammo. Nothing useful. Nothing useful. Got Claire making snap judgments. We're alive. Did it hurt us? Not too badly, but, wait, where are we? A bronze plate with a picture on it. It gives an idea of where you need to position the bookshelves. First you don't succeed, try dent. Big gap, small gap, big gap. They go from... Sorry, are we talking about the health line, Wirebrain? You mean like within caution? The spikes are different colors. I didn't realize. Oh, thank you, Rocket Kev. Really appreciate it. Yeah, I hope you have a good night's sleep. I'll get to catch one of your streams soon. There we go. Oh, I think that was back by the key. Serpent stone, or serpents. Yeah, that was a pretty easy puzzle, Wirebrain. Really straightforward. Wait, there's a vase down there. I don't think I've checked the vase yet. Yeah, I know, it's getting late. Oh. Eventually, but I'm having fun. Did I check this one? Oh wait, maybe this was where I found the flame rounds. I think. Didn't see a door up there. Yo, Dino Crisis one that had a lot of more puzzles. I don't have a copy of that. I only have a copy of Dino Crisis 2. It's one of those games I remember seeing Dino Crisis 1 at GameStop at some point and still kicking myself for not buying it. But Dino Crisis is a bit harder, isn't it? Somebody was playing that. Was it Joey or Evelicia? Oh, Dino Crisis 2 is a great game. Fun take on survival. Oh, so Dino Crisis 1 has more puzzles and Dino Crisis 2 has more action. Which is kind of the vibe I'm getting from RE1 versus 2 so far. Did they make a Dino Crisis 3 and it just wasn't ported to PC? Or shit, I saw something move. Shit, is that... Oh, the Resident Evil shift from puzzle to action is not as drastic. I think that was a wall venom, but he didn't attack me. Oh, the lickers are blind. Hey, just like me. Hey, kinship. Oh, okay. I was thinking about the cutscene, and it didn't seem to pay attention to her until she sort of gasped. Yeah, I do no spoilers, but I guess I'll allow that one, because it's just, you know, more like a gameplay hint. Yeah, I'm sure this game has enough plot twists that... Probably I could have figured it out after more encounters with him, because that explains why, you know, I was right there, and he didn't attack me. Yeah, I appreciate that, Wirebrain. Okay, they tell you in a note later on. The question is, do I want to fight this one up here, or go down to the lower level? Well, let's try... Just in case. I don't know, if they only take 5 bullets each, do I want to waste a grenade on one? For some reason I always feel like it should be 15 instead of 13 rounds. Fight him. to be like one green herb in there. I feel like if I shoot the grenade launcher, like pointing down, like looking at the angle, it's gonna be too close and it's gonna damage me. Okay, this time we'll actually fight him. Up using a whole bunch of them on the final boss. It would have been pretty hard if we didn't have grenade. I know, we found a rocket launcher to use on him, didn't we? Forgot about that. Yeah, let's try out our new toys. Oh. Did it? Ah. Stupid. Yeah, I'm guessing it's our network. Like our internet. Now, before next stream, I'll try resetting it. Wait, did I? Equipped nothing! Dear. It's not saying anything. It'll just be like disconnecting, reconnecting when it does that sort of thing. It's not like a real full-fledged error. Which is good. Okay. Do I? Shoot, do I? I can't think after that. It'll take more than one or two bullets. That was a tough liquor. Too bad. Oh, with the stream crashing. Or hiccuping. It seems to be broken. It won't work. Yeah. Well, I started recording a backup, fortunately, so it's gonna be hell to edit, but only up to a point. I've got up with uploading almost everything. Square hole. Let's put a round peg in it. Or, you know, oh yeah. Me and my bright ideas. But hey, we needed to kill the liquor, so glad we did. Nothing particular. Rusted gears. shit. That's better than the alternative of the way the zombies stuck around in RE1. Thanks for the tip about the grenade, Wirebrain. I don't know if I got a good hit on him, because it kind of looked like he was burning, but then I think he took 5 pistol rounds. Shit, a dead end. I think I saw another zombie too. Okay, he's dead. A trick with the blood pool is helpful. Safely get past him here, even though it's slightly wider by the door. Yeah, I see. Wait, is this? Oh, this is the entry hall. See, there's the statue. So small. Get close and then aim up. It looks like she's aiming too high. Yeah. Shit, 2 more. One did have been one that I hadn't shot before I was gonna kick his head off. Oh, gotcha, Wirebrain. Oh, you mean aiming up to headshot the zombies? And hey, niftiness. Yeah. Resident Evil 2. How are you tonight? You guys, please go check out Niftiness. So Claire never gets the shotgun. Oof. Can't believe I didn't get the damn crossbow. Oof. Me and my desire to conserve ammo. Oh. Yeah, he's dead. She's really limping, is that? Oh yeah, we're in danger. We better eat the super herb. Yeah. They're good things to have, except I didn't get the crossbow at the start because I was like too too many zombies, too much of a waste of ammo, and we might not get it. Yeah, she lives. No, I definitely figured it was time for some herb. Glad I was carrying that. But I'm doing all right, thanks, Niftiness. Glad you're doing well. An emergency ladder. I was hoping there'd be another one. Like, it seemed like it would be too harsh if, you know, you miss it once and then you never get it. So this will be a useful way to fast travel up and down stairs. Oh, and this will make it easier to go back and get the crank from the chest downstairs. I'm feeling venturesome. Especially like this tune. Oh, even better. Glad I explored before backtracking. Are the flame rounds and acid rounds for the grenade launcher? I really thought those were supposed to be shotgun shells. Ah, gotcha. Thanks, that's good. I would have just not been using them the whole time. Ooh, the lighter. I bet we can go into the ventilation shaft now. Maybe find that dumb kid in there. Be like, hey, dumb kid, get out of the ventilation shaft. In fact, get out of the zombie-infested city. What is that? Oh, secretary's diary, eh? April 8th. I accidentally moved one of the stone statues on the second floor when I leaned against it. When the chief found out about it, he was furious. I swear the guy nearly bit my head off like a licker, screaming at me never to touch the statue again. If it's so important, then maybe he shouldn't have put it out in the open like that. April 7th. I heard that all the art pieces from the chief's collection are rare items, literally worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. I don't know which is a bigger mystery, where he finds those tacky things, or where he's getting the money to pay for them. May 10th. I wasn't surprised to see the chief come in today with yet another large picture frame in his hands. This time, it was a really disturbing painting depicting a nude person being hanged. I was appalled by the expression on the chief's face as he leered at the painting. Why anyone would consider something like that a work of art is beyond my comprehension. I'm reporting the chief to HR, though they probably won't do anything. Gotcha. So they're special rounds. Oh yeah, and you can load them. I think the first game did have something like that, but now I can't remember if it was for the grenade launcher or the shotgun. So we saw that picture, but now maybe we should examine it a little more closely. I don't think we need to save just yet. I think in the first game they gave us like 3 ink ribbons per like ribbon we found, but maybe we're playing on the easy difficulty then, and we're playing on normal now. Actually, I should combine them. Oh, there. Yeah, I like combine everything. That's what I do to make it more efficient. Ooh, magazine rack. None of these look useful. There's no zombicide today. Southern Living versus the Southern Unliving. High lights them on fire. National Geographic violence. Brain Eaters Quarterly. Yeah. Brain Eaters cut up into quarterly. Newslick. Better Homes and Gore Fests. Where was I? Oh yeah, up here. Yes, we only need to use the crank in one place, or... I don't know, can we take it? I don't know. The crank's just gone. The machine ate it right up. Switch. I will soon. Power source for the clock? The gears are clean. I'm sorry, what clock? Dear Spooky Penthouse Letters, I never thought I'd experience a story like this outside of your letters department. A big clock tower. Resident Evil taking pot shots at the competition, eh? The iron plate seems to have been recently moved. Right. And there's Alucard and Maria hanging out inside. I've seen clock towers in a few games. And now should I press it? No kidding! Capcom bought out the Clock Tower series. Can I remember, like, the second Clock Tower game. It was the first one released in the US. Like, competed with the first Resident Evil game. Gotta play that series. Did that move the... plate? No. We don't know what the Switch did. Okay, so Clock Tower 3 was then a Capcom game. I'm glad they bought out the competition, but then, yeah, kept doing stuff with it for a little while. Yeah, nothing there. Well, the Switch hopefully did something, and we can... the floor again. surprised we haven't found another key yet. We found that stone tablet. So the first, I didn't realize that they did remake the SNES version on the PS1, but they gave it a different name. So then we did eventually get both of them here. Seems like such an interesting series, and just especially the fact that they were doing, like, proto-survival horror on the SNES. Another narrow hallway. Down you go and down you stay. Yeah, it looks like she's looking down at his corpse as she walks past. Ah! Oh, and then our clock tower 2 is not related to the first two in the series. God, they make it complicated. It really looks like she's like keeping her eye on them. Which is a nice touch, if I'm not just reading into something that isn't there. Gotcha, it's like, it doesn't actually relate to the plot of the first two games, really. Yeah, Scissor Man. Remember, I read a bit about it when I was doing research on game IPs at one of my internships. and that's the name they slapped on it here. Oh dear. Don't want to get any closer. Well, that explains why the zombie was burning. Have you played any of the Clock Tower games, Wirebrain? Some of one, all of two, or a little of two, and then finished all of three. I'll probably play the whole series eventually. I really want to try the SNES one, but I have heard it's hard. In the first game, sometimes they were cool to just, you know, hang out, but other times they'd come after you. Oh, crashed again. Hopefully most of these are just brief. Shit. Oh no, wait. Damn it, I'm blocking. Okay, I only see two ravens, but... Is that a corpse they're standing near? I kind of think that's a corpse. Oh, okay, they're blocking my way. Yeah. This is that. Is this the same door? I hear them now. We're finding different ways to get around this place quicker. Pig room in the northeast. Looks like this is... Oh yeah, sorry, maybe I was like responding when it cut out, but you said you played like some of one, a little of two, and all of three. It is cool that you've gotten to experience like several of the games, Wirebrain. Back down there. To see. So it looks like there may be a way to get around the ravens, but I'm not positive. We definitely. Wait. Oh, right, the lighter. Shaft, and that's where we'll find the kid. I don't know if any of you guys have played the Aliens arcade game, but it's also part of the plot in the hat where you have to. A kid crawls out of the ventilation shaft, and then you have to save the kid. God, I haven't seen that movie in a long time. I was on the second floor. I just noticed the footsteps sounded different for a second. Struggle Within and Ghost Head are Clock Tower spin-offs? I don't think I'd heard of those. Are they like old spin-offs or are they more recent ones? Didn't realize there were that many. Yeah. Suns and moons. I should look at this. That's a stake. Oh, I see. That was Clock Tower 2, The Struggle Within. Gee, it's like they're trying to confuse us. Shoot, where was on the first floor? Mysteriously sealed. Gotcha. It was Ghost Head there and Struggle Within here. It wasn't in the office. Damn it. Then it was on that side. I guess it was on the first floor, and I'm just not remembering. Suspense every time you open a door. Saying, like, the actual clock tower 2 was just called clock tower here. I wonder why we didn't get the SNES one. They just thought it wouldn't sell well in America. Because we didn't get Sweet Home either. You don't need to use this right now. Nine so fast. I didn't think I tried to go up those steps, did I? By the, was it the heart door? It was Nintendo. Oh. Yeah, I remember seeing, like, that there was a translated ROM hack, even. I think I even saw about, like, back on Home of the Underdogs in the, like, circa 2000. Yeah, should have known it was friggin' Nintendo. They're, we're so family friendly, we would never do this unspeakable filth, like, Mortal Kombat with a blood patch or blood code you could enter. That's evil and despicable. And wait, there's money in violence? Pre-order Doom 64 today. Yeah, hey, let's make an M-rated horror launch title for the GameCube. Nintendo. You do like your money. Principles are all very well and good, but we're running businesses here. Oh, right. We would never release Night Trap on a Nintendo platform, and now we have Night Trap on the Switch. Howard Lincoln. You are so full of shit, and I hope that history will remember you in this light. Oh yeah, times change, yeah. But principles don't. Hey, Asmodan. Welcome in. How are you doing tonight? You guys, please go check out Asmodan. God, where would we be without the maps? Yeah. Okay, no, the heart door does appear on the map. It's just like a really dark color, so you have to look closely to see it flashing. I'm sorry, guys. That was a waste of time. There's basically nothing we can do without confronting the zombie ravens. Oh, man. You got called into work. Even though you were already tired. That sucks. I'm glad you got, you know, a shift from a monetary standpoint, but still, that's exhausting. And you'd have to do a full shift at that point. There is another way in there. Since you did that shift, Asmodan, you get, more time off. You get to skip some other shift. So I wonder if we're going to find wire or something to repair the shutter control. I could have taken the emergency ladder, damn it. I completely forgot. Oh yeah, just you. Secretary mentioned leaning against the statue and it shifting. I wonder if it had to do with that puzzle. This is just a dead end with no items, right? Yeah. There's something on the wall here. Yeah. Just decorative. Oh, wait, is that? I thought that might have been the clock tower, but I think it's just a window. A fancy window. Thank you. problems. Oh, right. Did I ever try this door? Or no, oh, that's the fire, right. Never mind that. Which fortunately does not spread. Sometimes in the first game they were cool with you, but I think that was mostly if they were in higher places and if they were more on your level, they would attack you. Of course, we only see two. Not that much longer, Stock. I'll probably wrap it up fairly soon. I know it's getting kind of late. We only, like, see two of the ravens. I know, they're crows, right? The crows. But they got in here, and we don't know if we fire a gun, if more are gonna swarm us. So the question is, do I attack them now and get off a couple? Oh, gotcha, Hespadon. Thanks for the... You're hanging out here, and I'm sorry you're so tired. It sounds like a long day. Auto pause is a scare in itself. The weather, we get off a couple of free shots and try and take them out, or try to walk past them and hope they're cool with us. Like the liquors were. Oh, hey, Techie Rob. Thank you so much for the resub. 21 months. I really appreciate it. You guys, please go check out Techie Rob, who streams a lot of retro games. So you were playing, was it a shmup the other day? Oh, Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. That is, not a shmup at all. But, sure, Wirebrain. Yeah, I'll take some advice. Oh, that's... Really sorry about that, Asmodon. But hopefully, since you did take the shift again this time, it's like... That's another one you won't have to do in the future. Yeah, of course, Techie Rob. Okay. No, we're doing something darker. Yeah, like sometimes I'll say, yeah, I'll take the advice, other times I'll try to figure it out on my own, but I appreciate, like, asking. Nancy Drew Resident Evil crossover would be something. Sorry, you only heard the raid? Yeah. like some Hitchcock-level shit. Claire's, not feeling too good. Oh, the sub got you stuck. But how are you, Techie Rob? And how are you enjoying the, what's it called? Ocarina of Time. Oh. So you're experienced enough that you're the de facto manager when the real manager isn't around. Hopefully they appreciate that. I don't know if we'll be able to make it back through there. Them crows. There we go. Mostly all one big open space. Let's look in here first. Pressure valve, it reads, excessive pressure may rupture the water tank. But we can't use the valve? Oh, maybe the handle's missing. Oh, you just started it. It takes a couple of years to solve. I kept intending. I was talking about streaming that at one point, because that's the only N64 game I own. But such a big commitment. Oh, it's a helicopter. Oh, now I see it. Oh, wow, Asmodon. I'm glad they took you back. Yeah. I know, that's what I was thinking, Wirebrain. Regrow or negro. And yeah, it was a helicopter. But welcome in, to XYMZ. How are you doing tonight? You know, I figure we'll have to find the, what's it called, the handle. Something for that water tank. Yeah, good on there, prepared. No, I haven't, XYMZ. This is my first time playing it. So, I'll be happy to get any percent completion. Are you a Resident Evil 2 fan? Good, you did have to have that shift, even if you were tired. there's a typewriter. Oh, is that? It is, the valve. And we don't have our ink ribbons. Oh, it is the crossbow. Nice. Now I feel a lot better about not having taken it at the start of the game. Especially since we haven't found any bolts. Okay, that caught me. Oh, you'd had several beers at that point. Shit, I mean, I'll have to kill them, but... I assume I'll have to kill them and try to get through that door, but... Eat a herb first. I feel like I'm at the very highest level of caution. Who knows what this will do? That's fun. Oh, thanks. I dodge them when I can. Good thing it works on that side. Interesting, we still have the handle. Guess we'll run into another valve. Was a cowardly helicopter pilot from the first game? I want to say Brad, but I don't think that's right. Yeah, that's kind of my thought, Wirebrain. Like, save ammo whenever you can. Because you'll need it. Brad Vickers. Chicken heart, like the episode of Lights Out. Weird horror radio shows of the 30s. Oh good, the bullet survived. Okay, well thank you for the lurk, Asmodon. That's probably everything. We're going to... Wait, shoot. Yeah, you would think the heat would, the whole fire would have destroyed the bullets, but no. Okay, so I... If we're trying to run back through the bird hall, I feel like we're going to get pecked a lot, so... I'm gonna try and fight my way through those two. Oh yeah, my pleasure, Asmodon. I always try to lurk in friend streams when I can. Especially like if I'm at work, I'll try and lurk in two streams simultaneously. I'm not using the headphones. It's bold of me to try and use a new weapon here, but... Oh, wait. hitting both of them? Six streams. Ugh. Is that... How does this weapon work? Oh, so each shot fires three arrows. Oh, okay. I was thinking 15 was pretty generous. I probably should have finished that last one off with a handgun, but whatever. Yeah, three rounds at once. I'm useful for hitting multiple zombies with that. It's too dangerous to go back outside. Well, fuck. And I think. Oh, there were ink ribbons by the typewriter. Thank God. Yeah, I better save, because it's possible I'll just get killed running through the crows. Cabin. Probably hasn't been working for some time. Doesn't appear to have been used much. Would you like to elaborate, Claire? Like maybe telling us what it is, if you can tell? At the start, but then more were flying in, it looked like. Here goes something. There's two on the ground. Isn't it? No, that's just one, but still. Can't see this ending well, but... He's been pecked to death. Wait, so where? Where's the other place we can use? Thanks, Wirebrain. I appreciate it. It's always good to see you. And yeah, we're gonna wrap up pretty soon. Look, even Claire's tired. Was all part of the same fire. Okay, I guess the helicopter crashed through the wall. Shit. The door is broken. There's no other choice but to take out the wall. Oh wait, there's a door. God, I bet it's that kid. Size of a fist. Through the window, through the wall, helicopter at the bathroom stall. I like it. An armored stone statue. The stand reads, Tyrannos the Brave revives with two lights. Tyrannos. That sounds a little close to Tyrant for my liking. Ink ribbon, but no typewriter. Put an ink ribbon in the clock. Nothing useful on this shelf. An oil painting wrapped in cloth. Neglected and covered with dust. There's a diamond. Wait, did we unlock everything on this floor? Yeah. Access those. I'm sorry, I'm trying to see how to access some of these rooms and it doesn't look like we can. I guess we gotta go down to the first floor and use the diamond key. Right. Putting it in there guarantees that we are going to run into a liquor. easier way to use a ladder than some games I've played. Pretty sure the one that looks invisible is the heart. That on the shutter control. Eagle. The first time we've died today, isn't it?
Resident Evil 2.
Okay, well, we'll wrap up soon.
Resident Evil 2.
He said Resident Evil 2, and then I repeated 2. I was trying to line it up, but... Oh. Oh, wow. You had a lot more save slots than I realized. You once again stepped into the world of survival horror. Good luck. Maybe we'll use that door later. Oh, thanks. I was trying to imitate it. Thank you. They have short attention spans, our feathered friends. Some kind of explosive. Yeah, nothing useful. Probably got to kill the liquor, because I assume after he breaks the mirror I can get into the interrogation room. This time I'll remember the optimal route. This time we'll be ready for him. Wait, which was it, this one? Thank you. I could climb on the table. I doubt I could do it quietly enough. Since I've got like acid and flame rounds too. I know this is the interrogation room, I guess that's the observation room. Still a caution. Can we climb through here? No, we can't climb through here. That would be silly. So it was worth it to kill him. Snakes and eagles. Might have been another diamond lock on the far side, but either way, I want to try and use this cord on the shutter control. I feel like we're close to finding the kid, and that'll probably be a good place to end for the night. Chances of us needing the eagle now. Hello. Connect wires on small electrical devices. Hey, that did work. And nothing else nasty is going to jump through those windows. We assume. Hey, Atari Beer Pong. Welcome in. How are you doing? You guys, please go check out Atari Beer Pong. It was... Oh dear. OBS has crashed. That old thing again. It's working fine for a while. Sorry, Atari Beer Pong, we'll have difficulty giving you a shout-out, but you guys, please go check out Atari Beer Pong. We play more of Dungeon Master, right? Oh, this is your favorite Resident Evil game. I'm enjoying it so far. I feel like I'm making better progress and maybe more confident than I was when I played Resident Evil 1. And there's a... The liquors are giving me grief, but I suppose that's to be expected. Yeah, we're playing the GameCube version. Which one did you play, Atari Beer Pong? Was it? Did I miss it? Goes through there. No, it's here. Yeah, I've been enjoying the story so far. Yes, discard the diamond key. Liking how it, you know, connects to the events of Resident Evil 1. You're trying to figure out... Oh, fuck! Oh, I forgot there was an N64 version, too, but... You played the original PS1 version. Nice. Like, yeah. Where's the nearest crate? Or chest? I gotta switch weapons, but I think there was a chest up on the second floor near here. There are like 3 zombies in a row. It's the crossbow is the way to go, even if I only got 3 shots. Wait, was it here? Prefer, or which storyline do you prefer in Atari Beer Pong, Claire or Leon? Probably only play one on stream, but I try the other in my spare time. And then they have the alternate game modes too. Wait, no, she didn't need to go upstairs. Nice. Like one round of 3 bolts can take out a zombie. One zombie. Both storylines are good. You like Leon a little bit more. Good. I'm worried about how little ammo we have. More extras and replayability. I like when they have so much, like with the multiple game modes. We dead. Yeah. Claire's getting there too. Shoot. Oh no, she's limping bad. Danger, yeah. Better use super herb. Oh, converging elements. Like from the, like if you play from the two different storylines. See, basically only like this magazine and one more. And I hear another guy in here. It's fun to see how, must be fun to see how they interact. Okay, thanks. Oh no. I played the game. It's conceivable I could play through both characters if people wanted me to. Ooh, yes, we will always use the lockpick. Plastic bomb. All I need now is to destroy the wall being blocked by the helicopter is a detonator. Oh, right. Now this is... Well, we found that, Sergeant What's-His-Name's evidence report. Yes, we will take the blowgun bolts. Ooh, a lot of them. So we knew where to find the plastic bomb in evidence. Well, you can fuck right off. Yeah, this is... No, this is my first playthrough ever of the game. I swear there was a blood-spurting hand stuck to me for a second. I only died once tonight. Died a lot more, last stream. Film. Ooh. We did find a dark room, didn't we? This clipping. God, so late my mind's playing tricks on me. I swear I saw that zombie's foot twitch. Oh, shoot. Let's see if our friend... is this... yeah. See if that friendly police officer we met is a zombie now. Friendly telekinetic police officer. Yeah, I played the GameCube remake of the first one, so not the original. Today's date, September 29th, Michael Festival. Or if we see him on the ground, and I just won't walk over his corpse. The modern remaster. It was just... it was like a remaster of the remake. Nothing suspicious. Wait, is that... that's a headless corpse. The reception desk. Yeah, like that's what I was thinking it was. Like, the same, the remaster was the same game as the remake, just better graphics. Memo to Leon. Congratulations on your assignment to the Raccoon City Police Department. We all look forward to having you as part of our team and promise to take good care of you. Welcome aboard from all the guys at the RPD. But not Chief Irons. Chief Irons hates you. Better at dodging these goons. Oh, here's the dark room. Perfect. I can develop film here. Fortunately, Claire knows how to. Now we just have to wait 8 hours. Oh, that was fast. Thank you. spare bolts in here, at least for now. And the anchor bones. I'll have to come back here anyway. It's late. I think we're close to being able to save the kid, who hopefully has a higher than Yobro level of intelligence, and I think that'll be a good place to save and call it a night. I mean, he looks still alive, but I feel like once we get closer, he's going to jump up and try to chew our throat out. I mean, relatively speaking, you know, he was, yeah, that's the door he telekinetically locked. Yeah, he's definitely, had a few bad experiences today. But I feel like he's got the key or something. Hey, officer, remember me? Out of the wall? No. Yeah, I know, and he got up. I mean, that was good. The game got me. And showing him transition to full zombie, that was cool. Oops. The retirement party. Won't be back. Oh, good. What were you doing with the detonator, officer? Oh, no. And now we can get the herb. I feel like whenever you're down to danger, it's worthwhile to make a super herb and eat that if that gets you up to 100%. Oh shoot. So now we won't be able to dodge this guy, we'll have to go the long way around or waste bullets on him. Legs. take more than one more bite. Yeah. I mean, ideally, you don't even want to get down to danger. One I came across on the second floor, but now I can't remember where. And now, just cardboard boxes. And fake health kits. Anyway, I already got everything out of there. Footsteps sound different though. Different there. Yeah. I said I was gonna get to the part where we save the girl, and I thought we were closer than we were, but I think that'll be a good stopping place, Doc. Yeah, I gotta wrap up for the night. She'll be fine. She survived this long. Won't hard to stop on my account. Oh, the music makes you more tired because you keep hearing the same tunes over and over. But then they stop when, you know, you leave a room. But yeah, I know, still limping. The chewed her and cut her pretty bad. If it marked the chests and typewriters on the map, but I feel like that's asking for too much. The game's like, we already let you save your game repeatedly, and, you know, if you put items in one chest, you can access them from any chest, so I don't know what you want. In the building. If you line up all your shots right, you can take out 2 zombies with those 8 bullets. We can just give you ammunition all the time. Finally. Press that water tank, put out the fire through the wall. Through 3, you had to really conserve your ammo and be strategic about who you killed and how. But then in Resident Evil 4, there is less of that. They're starting with RE4. Enough C4 to clear the wall, but it needs a detonator. Oh, do we have to combine them first? Clear the wreckage away with this. Probably gotta run back through Crow Alley. What time is it? Ah, shit. You know, I'm sorry, guys. It's too late. I just gotta save and then call it a night at this point. God, is it worth saving? I feel like we've done enough. Through six, more action and spectacle. That is Crow Alley. And the story of Resident Evil 4 got a little silly at times. That's the one where you have like a NPC partner who keeps screaming for help and stealing your ammo, right? Pleasure, niftiness. So I'm gonna try and tomorrow or Tuesday do a makeup stream since I missed Short Horror Saturday. And then Wednesday I'll stream as normal, but I don't know. They're shutting down our building, so I'll be home early, and I'm trying to decide if I should play more Resident Evil 2 then and try and get further, or if I should try to finish the Doom reboot. Because I only have one level left, but, you know, if the final boss is nasty, it could take me several hours? Who knows? Whatever. We'll be doing one of those two on Wednesday. And I know I need to... I'll start a new game soon. But... that's pretty much what's coming up. And then... yeah, got a bunch of stuff I need to plan out. But thank you, Tari Beer Pong. I appreciate you hanging out. And Niftiness and all you guys. Okay, let's find somebody to raid. Stealthy Golems playing Amiga games. Just TJ is playing the Lion King. Why? Why would you do that? It's not online anymore. It's Ruby playing. Oh. FMV horror games. Let's say Dragon of the West. We don't get to do that all the time. And he's playing more Celeste. Oh. Right, with the OBS crash, I'll have to do it through online. Working? Yeah, working. Now, thank you, everybody, for coming to hang out. Watch me stumble and deliberate my way through survival horror. And thank you guys for the resubs tonight and for the contributions, the community challenge, and everything else, and just for being here. I appreciate all the chatters and all the lurkers. And you guys can follow me on Twitter and MySpace, where I post stream announcements. And you guys can find VODs of my past streams up on YouTube. And won't it be fun to combine the 12 VODs from this stream? But... Oh yeah, and just a reminder, on Wednesday I will... For the old community challenge, I will drink a... alcoholic cocktail of citrus and yogurt. Because I promised I would. Thanks, Beer Pong. I hope that everybody... has a good night. May no wall venoms get the drop on you, and may any zombies you kick be decapitated. And say hi to Dragon of the West, and yeah. See you guys for more horror.